Hi, my name is Nick Stasoulis, and I am a hydrologic technician with the main office of the New England Water Science Center. In this screencast, I will discuss some of the common issues identified during field review of midsection measurement data collected in RiverSurveyor Stationary Live. One of the most common issues in midsection ADCP measurements is a lack of angle correction or angles that are measured incorrectly. First, ensure angles were corrected for using either the XYZ method, which requires the unit to be held in a specific orientation, or the ENU method, which uses the compass and a tagline azimuth to correct for angles automatically. Indicated angles are easily viewed in the transect tab and the samples tab. With the XYZ method, errors are usually caused by the user not holding the unit at the correct orientation, causing angles that do not make sense hydraulically, as we see here. With the ENU method, errors are usually related to the azimuth entered in the software being measured incorrectly, the compass not being calibrated properly, or compass errors during the measurement, either due to a poor calibration or interference from a local source. Good documentation is always important to confirm angles that are indicated by the software or noted by the user. In this case, the angles may be very reasonable, or due to a compass error or misalignment, and without good field notes, we wouldn't have any way of confirming them. Ideally, errors with either method would be identified during data collection and addressed. With XYZ, there is not much that can be done to correct erroneous angles during review. With ENU, only the tagline azimuth can be edited if it was known to be entered in error. Another common issue when reviewing RSSL data is inconsistencies in the extrapolation method selected by the user and the selected extrapolation methods not representing the measured data. First, ensure the selected methods agree with the site conditions. For example, if making an ice measurement, ensure the ice water surface type is selected and that the no-slip, no-slip extrapolation method is used. Also, evaluate the velocity profile plot to ensure the appropriate method and exponent are used and applied consistently to all stations. Here is an example of where the measured data and the extrapolated data don't seem to make much hydraulic sense. A separate screencast in this series discusses extrapolation in more detail. OSW Memo 2014.02 requires a screening distance to be entered in the manufacturer's software, which includes RSSL. This screening distance is equal to 0.52 plus the transducer depth. In open water measurements, this is easy to compute, but in ice conditions, the screening distance is referenced from the water surface, so you must add the 0.52 to the transducer depth below the water surface, which would include ice thicknesses. If you don't see blacked out data on the contour plot, review the screening distance settings. OSW Memo 2010.07 requires an independent temperature comparison for each ADCP measurement, and this includes midsection data. A common issue observed during midsection review is a change in temperature due to the instrument not being equilibrated. Ideally, this would be prevented by the independent temperature check obtained before the measurement. Changes in temperature are easily seen in the time series tab, or viewing the tabular data for each station on the left of the screen. If large differences in the temperature are noted, consider entering the independent reading on the system tab. Understand that this fixes the temperature for the entire measurement. Separation in SNR is sometimes observed in the profile plot on the transect tab in fast velocity conditions where the ADCP is not deep enough in the water. This separation is likely due to air enchantment under the transducer. Again, if observed during data collection, the ADCP can be lowered into the water, but during playback, there is nothing that can be done to remove these anomalies, and it's difficult to determine how they might affect the final discharge. When using the midsection method with ADCPs, it's important to select the appropriate references, and a fairly common mistake is the improper use of these settings. In the System tab, ensure the track reference is set to System. It should not be set to bottom track, as this could introduce errors in moving bed conditions or places where bottom tracking is difficult. If there are errors in the bottom track or vertical depths, they cannot be screened out, and the best option is to change to the other reference, assuming it doesn't have the same errors. Also, ensure the discharge method is set to midsection, not mean section. Another common error in the settings is this coordinate system, which tells the software how you would like to compute angles. XYZ is used to correct for angles in cases where you hold the unit at a known orientation to the flow. If this is not done, you cannot use XYZ. ENU is used in cases where a tagline azimuth is obtained and the compass is used for angle correction. Be aware that these settings can be made for each station individually, and you would want to ensure they are consistent for the entire measurement using the Apply to All button. More information on the use of these references can be found by visiting the OSW Hydroacoustics webpage and viewing the podcasts on open water and ice midsection ADCP use. Possibly the largest source of error and uncertainty with all midsection measurements is the use of a poor cross-section, improper stationing, and use of an instrument not appropriate for the channel conditions. When reviewing the data, consider how a different cross-section or instrument might improve data collection. During data collection, ensure your stationing defines the river conditions and flow, and insert additional stations if needed. When possible, use an instrument and deployment that is appropriate for the depth and velocity conditions you'll be measuring in.